Hey everybody, this is going to be the sixth part in my Poor Man's Home Gym series, and I just thought I'd show you a couple more of my training methods and devices, and how I kind of improvise as I go along. For instance, tonight I wanted to show you some of my boxing training and how I learned to work on my footwork and keep my endurance up, that sort of thing. And tonight, for instance, I went looking for my jump rope and it had disappeared on me to who knows where, so I had to improvise and come up with a solution. So what I did, I had an old electrical cord, extension cord, and I just cut a couple of pieces of PVC pipe, and you put a knot on it, slip through the handle, and then knot it on the opposite end. So you have two handles of PVC pipe and a pretty heavy electrical cord. And it makes a pretty good impromptu, jump rope if you need to. So, since I made this, I might as well show you some jump roping. And I haven't done this in a long time, but I'm getting started again. Because like I said, you guys know if you've been watching, I'm trying to get back in shape. But anyway, I'm going to do a little rope skipping. Maybe Jordan's going to try to zoom in and show the methods I use. Okay. Now, when you first start out, and I have limited ceiling clearance, so we'll see how this goes. When you first start out, you jump rope like when you're a kid, you know? So, and try to keep the jumps not too extreme, okay? Just jump just enough to get up off the ground and do it. Then you might go like 1 foot, and then your other foot. And you can kind of plunge, like so. I don't have enough room to do the double jump, but it kind of gave you an idea of what I was talking about. And that will, as you can tell by my breathing, it'll make you breathe hard, get a good workout, and it'll beef up your calves to where you're used to being on your toes all the time, which obviously is very important when you're boxing, okay? So anyway, PVC pipe, electrical cord, and you're ready to rock. And the next thing, if you can see me, Jordan, is I wanted to show you a style of jumping jack that I learned from my father, and he said this was a boxer's jumping jack, and that's what I've always called it. And basically, your regular jumping jack would be like so. Not everybody's done these, okay? Like in PE. Now, a boxer's jumping jack, instead of going over your head like so, what you're gonna do is go out, together, right, together, and left, together, out. And then we're just going to repeat that, okay? So at first you're just going to go out, together, right, together, left, together, out, right, left, out, right, left, out, okay? And as you notice, I started doing a little motion, and that's where it starts to feel more like boxing, okay? And you're going to do a little shoulder dip, like you're punching, and you can even punch while you're doing them, okay? So you go out, and you learn to kind of move around, and it teaches you to be light on your feet, okay? And you can throw uppercuts in there, you can learn to backpedal, and then, there's endless variations. And you can do the little skip I was doing, like when I was jumping rope, like so. And you just, right, left, two, so, okay? Out, right, left, like so, okay? Then, it's important, when you're fighting and you can, they teach us martial arts, boxing, everything, it's all about the angles, okay? You don't really want to attack straight on. And you never want to retreat straight back, okay? So you learn to move on angles, like at 45 degree angles. So if a guy's crushing in, you're going to jump back at the 45s, okay? Same way as when you go in, instead of hitting them head on, you're going to want to step to the side, okay? And come in at that kind of angle. It throws them off. You're evading their punches as you come in, and then you can lay your punches on, okay? So, and that's what I work on when I do these. I'll just start out normal, then I'll start throwing a little more, dip and bob in there, okay? And then after a while, you learn to backpedal a little quicker, okay? And you notice when I backpedal, I don't go straight back, okay? You want to divert their power, get out of their way. So you want to go back at the angles. Now, you can also build a lot of power in your legs for punching by lunging, okay? And this is going to build your legs up. So while you're doing, you want to lunge forward to attack, you can dip like so, okay? So anyway, That gives you some idea of what I would call a boxing jumping jack. This will build your endurance, also helps you learn to evade attack, as well as get inside their defenses, okay? Now, how much time do you leave?
5:13.
Okay, I'm gonna hurry up, I don't want this to be a 10-minute video. The last trick, I'm just gonna do a little bit of this. This is an old-time boxer's training method. Again, I'm utilizing an electrical cord because that's what's handy. You guys couldn't find any rope.
Oh, there's our weapon wall that we practice with out here, by the way.
I got some nails here. You can hang this up. And I got to tell you, I wish I could attribute this to a particular boxer, but it was either, I believe it was Jack Dempsey. If I'm wrong, sorry. But what they used to do is between the ring posts, they would tie a rope. And this, you know, closely approximates that sort of level. And what you're going to do is you're going to get squatted down like so, okay? So your shoulders never rise above this line. Okay, and what you're going to do is work on your bottom weave underneath this line, okay? And what that allows you to do is you learn to stay squatted while you're fighting, okay? Because it's necessary, because when you've got a slight squat to your stance, you can move quicker, you know, you can bottom weave, get out of the way. You can explode through punches, for instance, when you're throwing uppercuts, okay? So this is just a neat device. It's almost free. Just tie any kind of string, line, rope across the room, okay, like the shed here, and then just work on that. And you can mix, you know, you can mix punches in there while you're doing it. And you're just staying low and you learn to stay squatted. It's going to build your legs up, same time, build up your endurance, and get you used to, like, staying squatted and in your power zone where you can really throw with some, and put some thump to those punches. So anyway, I hope this helps. I'm maybe out of breath trying to talk and do it. But anyway, as I get in shape, you'll notice I'll be able to do this stuff a lot easier. But you guys are kind of inspiring me to stick with this, so we'll see how this goes. And I hope if anybody's out there is an aspiring fighter, that some of these training tips will help you in the future. So anyway, thanks for watching. I'll see you later.